How important is a clean uninstall? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's the question. When it comes to uninstalling programs on Windows, is there really no way of removing all its residual and/or leftover files? I've tried multiple uninstallers and cleaners, but I always find something left in a folder or in the registry. Bottom line here is that it rarely matters at all. And on top of that, the cure can sometimes be worse than the disease. But yes, uninstalling programs can be very messy for a variety of reasons. But seriously, it rarely matters if uninstalling a program leaves things behind. The program is gone as far as you're concerned. There might be some registry settings or some files left lying around, but most commonly, that's completely inconsequential. People love to dunk on the Windows registry as the source of most of its problems. And while the registry is indeed a complex beast, unused or leftover registry entries just don't affect performance appreciably. The technology implementing the registry is actually pretty efficient. Even leftover files have minimal impact. Leftover files rarely use a significant amount of disk space. When I diagnose nearly full drives, for example, it's almost always something else that turns out to be the space hog. Sometimes it's even on purpose. When you uninstall something, there's usually no way to tell the uninstaller whether you're uninstalling this forever, never to be used again, or installing it for now and might reinstall it later. The difference can be important. If you're uninstalling it forever, it makes complete sense that all traces of the program be removed. There's no point in keeping anything for software you'll never see again. However, if you might reinstall it, then things are less obvious. You might want to preserve settings you've made, for example. You might want things like templates or other configuration files to be saved as well, so that when you reinstall the program, your prior configuration and customization work isn't lost. Sometimes an uninstaller will ask, "Great." Sometimes it doesn't. It just makes an assumption. Most often that assumption is to leave things behind in case you reinstall later. Now, I've long been anti-registry cleaner. What's the best registry cleaner, what to use and not, has my thinking, including which cleaners to use if you must. If it helps you make the decision, I can't recall ever running a registry cleaner on my now 5-year-old primary desktop machine. It's always run just fine. I just don't consider registry cleaners as a solution to any practical problem. Uninstallers, on the other hand, are tools that I do use from time to time. I used Revo Uninstaller, but there are several good equivalent tools. I don't use uninstallers as part of any kind of routine cleanup, though. I'm diagnosing a problem with a specific application, then sometimes a more aggressive uninstall, cleaning out more than the default uninstall might, and resolve some issues. The risk, of course, is that registry cleaners and uninstallers accidentally remove things that turn out to be important. It's one reason I always recommend a full backup prior to running either kind of tool. With registry cleaners, overcleaning can manifest in completely random ways, ranging from the system no longer booting, which is thankfully very rare, to minor features either in Windows or specific applications no longer working as they should. There's no way to predict the impact. It's random. When uninstallers uninstall a little too much, the damage is usually, though not always, limited to other programs on your computer no longer working. Perhaps a shared component was accidentally removed, or information in some other program no longer being available. It's usually benign, but often requires that the original or the affected applications be reinstalled or their data files be recovered from backups. Now, the counterargument to everything I've just said is something called software rot. Software rot is the slow decline in performance and/or stability of your system. It's most often associated with installing and uninstalling lots of different applications over time. Each uninstall leaves something behind, and over time, all that cruft has a noticeable impact on your system. Installing and uninstalling lots of software is the most visible cause, but there's a strong case to be made that updates, both system and application updates, can kind of lead to the same thing. Software rot is not the issue it once was. I no longer believe it's anything most of us need to be concerned about. The software has improved to a point where software rot eventually gets dealt with naturally by something we do for ourselves for other reason, either getting a new machine or reinstalling Windows. The ultimate cleaning is indeed reinstalling Windows from scratch, or like I said, getting a new machine, followed then by reinstalling only the applications you actually use. A reinstall begins by erasing everything. All the leftovers, the cruft, is gone. Then, by setting up Windows afresh and installing only apps you actually use, your machine will contain only what's needed. Of course, at this point, the cycle begins anew. You'll start getting updates and installing and uninstalling software. The bottom line here, of course, is to avoid installing software you don't need. But in the long run, I don't think you need to spend a lot of time worrying about what's left when you uninstall something. Only when you're tracking down a specific problem might be it worth investigating whether more aggressive cleaning tools are actually called for. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/180292. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.